All right, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Prism World Tour, the second Prism project with IndyFringe. The Prism project was founded in 2009 at Ball State University with the mission of helping exceptional students develop social skills while preparing an exceptional show. Since its inception, the Prism project has spread from Muncie to New Orleans, Iowa, Michigan, Connecticut, and now Indianapolis. Over the past 8 weeks, our performers have been hard at work on their music, dance, and drama numbers, and they are excited to share the fruit of their labor with you today. But first, we would like to recognize the generous people who have made it possible to bring the Prism project to Indy. Thank you to the co-founders of Ball State's Prism Project, Ryan Harrigan, Amy Harrigan, and Michael Dane for supporting us along the way. Thank you to Pauline Moffitt for passionately pursuing this project over the last 4 years and for providing the space for our performers to work. Thank you to all the volunteers who have invested in this project in so many ways, and of course, a very special thank you to our donors. Impact 100, the Emily Fund, Katrina and Frank Basile, Mr. and Mrs. Thomas Mara, and Jan White in honor of Summer White Lynch. The Prism Project at IndyFringe would not be possible without your generous support. The very first Prism Project at IndyFringe took place in November when our kiddos performed Oh, the Places You'll Go, a theater, dance, and music extravaganza all about their dreams for the future, the challenges they might face, and how they'll keep working to make their dreams happen. And that first show left our performers feeling confident and ready to conquer the world. So for our second show, they've decided to do just that. Our Prism performers are taking this show on the road so they can share their talents with the world and do a little exploring. Who knows what kind of music we'll hear, dances we'll see, or people we'll meet along the way. So without further ado, let's kick off this Prism World Tour. Please help me welcome our Prism performers and buddies to the stage as they sing their own special rendition of On Top of the World by Imagine Dragons.
The sky is always blue and the grass is always green. All around the world it's just the same.
Traveler and has visited Japan with his family.
he's offered to show us around and share a bit of Japanese culture with us. In fact, he used GarageBand to compose a song inspired by Japanese music, and he's going to share it with us today. Please welcome Cannon to the stage as he shares his Japanese composition.
As they dance to Ricky Martin's Vida.
Let's just dance in the sun. Everybody grab someone. Let me help make us one. It's a celebration.
Together, people, every nation. Put your hands in the sky. Venimos a vacilar, venimos a disfrutar. Vamos todos a gozar, vamos todos a cantar. Vida, 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 vida. Everyone across the world.
Wow, what a blast. Our stop in Latin America didn't disappoint. And even though they might not speak the same language, eat the same foods, or live in the same place as us, the people in Latin America love to dance, listen to upbeat music, and have a good time with their friends. Those are all things we love too. But I wonder, could we really become friends with someone who is so different than us? What if they dress differently than us? Or don't speak the same language, or like to do the same things? Well, our friend Chancellor decided to write a scene about trying to befriend someone from a different country, and he's going to perform it for you now. In this scene, Chancellor and his buddy Allison play people from two different countries that meet for the first time. Let's see what happens. Please welcome Chancellor and Allison to the stage. For us. Just because someone is from another country doesn't mean we don't have things in common, just like those two characters who love to laugh and to play soccer. So maybe when we meet someone new, we need to look past all the differences on the surface to see their true colors. Once we see what's on someone's heart, we realize we're not that different after all. And here to sing about this is our good friend Aaron. Aaron is going to be joined today by his little brother. He's going to help him sing his song today. Please welcome Aaron and his brother Joshua to the stage as they sing True Colors.
Oh,
look what's in people's hearts, we'll see that we're not so different after all. I bet we're going to make a lot of new friends on the rest of this world tour. So, what are we waiting for? Let's go! Our next stop is Africa, where they love a good beat. Please welcome our Prism performers back to the stage as they play some African music.
Panama, 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 Pan
Jacob, Elizabeth, and Miss Juzette. The next stop on our journey is Vietnam in Southeast Asia. Our performers love stories of brave superheroes who use their powers to save the world from evil villains. So, they decided to explore an old Vietnamese folktale. But the hero in this tale is different. He's just a young boy. Can he save his village from a vicious man-eating monster? Let's find out. During our performer's rendition of the tale, please listen closely for a special sound effects recorded by Thomas on his violin. Please welcome our Prism stars to the stage as they perform How Bok Ho Killed the Monster with Four Mouths. Once a terrible monster lived in a village. It had four mouths to eat up its victims and five noses to smell where they might be hiding. Everyone is afraid of this terrible monster because it went out every night looking for people to eat. Nobody could kill it because the monster ate everyone who came near it. Finally, the villagers had a meeting. They decided each family in turn should offer a person to be eaten by the monster. In this way, they hoped the monster would kill only one person a day instead of several in a single night. Everyone agreed to this plan except a young man named Bok Ho, which means the poor one. Although Bok Ho was indeed poor, he was also brave and cunning.
We must kill the monster! We must not give in!
But everyone was afraid of the monster. And they did not think anyone could kill the monster. Instead, they began to offer the monster one victim every day, and the monster stopped going out at night looking for people to eat. One day, the villagers told Bok Ho's family that in 1 week, it would be their turn to offer a victim up to the monster.
I will go and I will kill the monster!
Bok Ho took a knife with a long, wide blade and went to the crossroads. There, he sharpened his knife. Heard the word monster, they hurried away, and Bok Ho was left alone. At last, a funny man with a long, round body hopped up to Bok Ho. He was dressed in bright red clothes. On his head, he wore a small red crown.
Good morning, Bok Ho. I'm the king of all the chili plants. May I ask you why you're here?
I am going to kill the monster. Why don't you help? The monster has stomped on many of the subjects.
How can a weak person like me kill the monster?
We are weak, but there's many of us. We will be strong. Go and bring rest of your friends.
King Chili hopped away, and just then, King Bee came buzzing by. Bok Ho told him he was going to kill the monster.
Why don't you help? The monster has stolen your honey and killed your subjects.
I will.
We are weak, but there's many of us. You will be strong. Go and bring rest on your friends.
The next next day, King Chili and King Bee came back, each with a friend. King Chili brought King Moss, who was very thin and wore ragged green clothes. King Bee came with King Snake, who looked just like a snake. About how they might best kill the monster, two other creatures joined them. One wore heavy armor and walked very, very slowly. He was King Tortoise. The other was King Fox, one of the world's most clever creatures. They were also very angry with the monster and they agreed to join the fight. Then, Bakko and his companions thought out a plan to destroy the monster. They spoke in whispers, for they did not want anyone to hear them. At last, the plan was complete, and Bakko and his companions separated. They agreed to meet later that night. That night, the monster ate his victim as usual and went to bed. Soon his snores filled the house. When the monster was fast asleep, Bakko and his friends gathered as silently as shadows in front of the house. The backyard, others slithered into the kitchen, and some hid in the garden. When the rooster crowed, Bakko was ready. He stood at the foot of the stairs to the monster's front door. His knife gleamed in his hand. Right on time, King Fox broke into the hen house and began chasing the hens. The hens made a terrible noise and woke up the monster.
Who dares to steal my hens? I'll eat you alive.
With that, the monster threw off his blanket and jumped out of bed. But King Snake was waiting for him under the bed. He bit the monster's big toe and quickly slunk back to bed.
Ow.
It was dark in the monster's room and he could not see King Snake, so he ran to the kitchen to get a light. There, King Chili and his men were waiting for them. They threw chili powder in his eyes and blinded him. The monster covered his eyes, howling with pain. Then King Tortoise blew out the lamp. The monster was so frightened that he ran out of the kitchen door. The King Bee dove down and stung the monster's face. The monster let out a giant scream and ran right out the front door. But King Moss had made the stairs slippery, so when the monster went down the front steps, he slipped and rolled right to the bottom. At the foot of the steps, Bakko was waiting with his gleaming knife. With one mighty stroke, Bakko slayed the monster. The monster was dead! The victorious army went in procession to the village to announce the good news. At the head of the procession was King Fox. Next came marching King Tortoise and King Chili. King Snake followed, with King Bee flying through the air right behind him. Then came King Moss, And last of all came Bakko, who was so tired from killing the monster that he could hardly walk. But Bakko was very happy. In the village, men, women, and children stood waiting along the streets to welcome him. The villagers welcomed Bakko and his friends as heroes, and they all celebrated the death of the monster for 3 days and three nights.
The story of Bakko is a lot like the heroic stories that we enjoy. Bakko and his friends may not have been very strong or had any superpowers, but they were willing to work together to fight for what is right. It didn't seem like they had much in common, but their differences turned out to be their greatest strength. Hey, wait a minute. That sounds a whole lot like the people we've met on our trip. On the surface, we all look pretty different, but deep down, we're all the same. And all those differences end up making our world that much more special. It would be boring if we all dressed the same, listened to the same music, and told the same stories. We're so grateful for the amazing people we've met on our trip and the culture they've shared with us. So, for our final stop on our Prism World Tour, we are heading to New Zealand, where we will be singing a blessing song for the world. Te Aroha is a traditional Maori song that translates to love, hope, and peace for us all.
Performers have been working hard on their music, dance, and drama numbers and we wanted to give you a peek behind the scenes of this year's Prism project. So as we make our way home, sit back, relax, and enjoy your in-flight movie.
This feeling inside my bones, it goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home, we're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it, so don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel a good, good creeping up on you, so just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. I can't stop the feeling, so just dance, dance, dance.
I can't stop the feeling,
so just dance, dance, dance. Come on.
Ooh, it's something magical. It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. I don't need no reason, don't need control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop that.
Under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine.
What's your name?
Elizabeth.
How old are you?
13.
13. What is your favorite part about Prism Project?
When we, like, perform, like, everything.
My name's Andreas. I'm 10 years old.
What is your favorite part about Prism Project?
I just like to do Bob was kill the monster.
What's your name?
Aaron.
How old are you? Favorite part?
Seven.
You're 7?
My name is Thomas. I am 9. I like theater.
My name is Tyree.
I am 11.
My name is Ripley. I am 7. I love everything about Prism. Oh.
Prism Project.
Prism Watch It.
Amazing performers. Not only did our Prism performers get to share their special talents with the world, but they learned a lot from their travels. They got to explore stories, music, and dances from different cultures, and learn that deep down, we really are a lot alike. We may be back home, but we won't lose the feeling that we are on top of the world. To celebrate our trip and safe return, please join us for one last round of Imagine Dragons on Top of the World.